realizing that this is, but hopefully you can continue where you left off after the meeting. It's 7 o'clock, so we'd like to go ahead and get started. I want to thank you all for being here tonight. My name is Sandy Golding. I'm president of Beaches Watch. And for anybody who may not know about Beaches Watch, we are a nonprofit, nonpartisan civic organization. And our mission is to educate and engage people in the issues that are coming before our local elected officials. And so we have these monthly meetings, the first Wednesday of every month, and with speakers that are talking about timely topics for the Beaches area. So we'll be getting to our guest speakers tonight. But before we do that, I want to mention, I hope everybody picked up a program when you came in, or an agenda. There's several announcements on here. We are doing our annual Give Back presentation in December. And what that is an opportunity for Beaches Watch to give back to a worthy nonprofit in the Beaches area that is doing something to enhance the quality of life for our Beaches community and our Beaches residents. So every year we've been doing that. This is like the fifth year, and we give a monetary donation to a local nonprofit because we want to help them to continue to do what they're doing. And so we have a deadline of November 7th. We would love for you guys to consider nominating a worthy nonprofit, and then in December we will be, the board will be making a decision between now and December, and then making the presentation at the December 3rd meeting. So if you know of any nonprofits, please email info@beacheswatch.com with the information about why you think the nonprofit should be chosen to be to get the give back donation this year. And then also, in line with what we are talking about tonight, Beaches Watch would like to have a chair, deck the chair again this year. We had one last year in the inaugural deck the chairs. And but to do that, there's a fee. And so if anybody would be interested in making a donation towards helping Beaches Watch to have a chair, then you can talk to Beth Kilgore, who's our treasurer, or Eileen Krimsky, who's sitting at the table. She's our membership chair. Or you can make a donation online. Or you can mail in a donation, but or Sybil Bonsbacher, she's the vice president of the board. Yeah, and any of our board members here tonight, and they'll be glad to help you out with that. We had one last year, and it was a lot of fun. We also have a sign-up sheet there, because we would love to have volunteers help us decorate the chair, because it was a lot of fun last year. I wasn't able to be there, but the volunteers that were there had a great time, so. And as we'll see in just a little bit, it's expected to be a wonderful event. I'm going to be even bigger and better than last year. So, also, we have elections coming up for board positions. And the secretary position, we have our current secretary is going to be stepping down before her two-year term is up. And so we are looking for someone who might be interested in filling the remainder of that one-year term. And the information's on here if you are interested, some information about what the secretary does. And if you are interested, then please email info@beacheswatch.com. We also have, I meant to put it out and I'll put it on the table, but we have a application packet for service on the board, and I can put that on the table, and if you're interested, you can fill out the application and submit that as well. And then we have a meeting on the 17th, Jack's Beach has a meeting, and I understand that I have the wrong time on here. George, is it 7 for the Jack's Beach Downtown Action Plan?
Oh, thank you.
Okay.
It's always
so
nice
tell
to,
us about it.
It's always nice to hijack Curtis's time, because he always does it to me, so this is kind of funny. We've got the action plan for family-friendly Jack's Beach, and we had a big meeting on this several months ago. We had a survey that many of you filled out. And so we're going to go through a draft action plan. This is a type of workshop for the public, not the city council, so the public will be able to comment on the action plan at the meeting. It's the 17th. It's at 7 o'clock. Sandy kind of misread the first message she got. We did send a follow-up at 7 o'clock on the 17th, Monday the 17th.
Yeah, I misread the 6:30 that was in the
You missed the 6:30 okay. The second one. It's always
okay.
The second one.
Yeah, well, yeah. The second one went out after the Beaches Watch email. I was just a little too fast. Sorry about that. Also, in November, we open up early bird renewal for our Beaches Watch membership, which is only $10 for individuals, $15 for families. So if you want to get a jump on renewal and not have to worry about it, you know, doing it after the first of the year, talk to Eileen or Beth again, or Sybil. And anyway, and then also the next meeting, as I mentioned before, is December 3rd. And so we'll have the board elections then, and we'll also have the give back presentation. And then also I want to mention, we have some soon to be elected officials, and then we also have some elected officials here tonight, so I'd like to recognize them. We have Mayor Harriet Pruitt from Neptune Beach. And then we have elected, but not in their seat yet, we have Bruce Thomason, who's with the Black Speech. And then we have George Forbes, who's the city manager, and we're glad to have you. Announcements. Are there any other announcements, actually? Harriet, would you like to give us an update real quickly about Pete's and anything else?
Pete's will be going on this year, 9-1. And also with the election, our election Friday at 10 o'clock will be a recount between Roy Diamond and Councilor Richard Arthur. And Roy Diamond so far has 4 votes over.
It's down to 2 now.
So we'll know, we should know Friday by lunchtime, I guess, now. And you know what they say, every vote counts.
Yes,
every vote counts. So, okay.
Any other announcements before we turn the floor over? Okay, well then, I would like to introduce Curtis Loftus. He is a former board member, Beaches Watch board member, and has been a huge asset to the community. He's also a Jack's Beach wave maker, like the first recipient of the Wave Maker Award. And for those of you who may or may not know, Curtis, he has a business here at the beach, the Curtis Group, and does a lot of wonderful things besides being a record holder for like the surfing marathon, right? And so anyway, so Curtis, please tell us about next year's. We're very excited to.
All right, well, thank you for having me tonight, and thank you for just, if I could pack it all in, just a chance to give you an update on Deck the Chairs for 2014, and then make a final plea for some volunteers at the end of this thing. This is kind of fun. My daughter did this last year. It'll give you a little flavor of last year's event. So we'll watch this, and may take all the time. I know I saw was Harriet. Harriet, I don't know if you remember that or not, when I was on the We were on the beach together, and I was like, gosh, these chairs are so beautiful. They're so iconic. They mean so much to the beach. We should just do something with these chairs, and it literally was the birth of Deck the Chairs. Didn't know exactly until I let it stew a little while where it would go, but it was, wow, we could decorate them. You know, we can do something. The lifeguards, they're right there near the pavilion area. The lifeguards are a 102-year-old entity, correct, George? Something in that neighborhood. So, you know, when you think about Jack's Beach, when you think about identity, and I know some of us in here pay attention to that, it just, what reflects a place or a person, that's what I pay attention to. It's what I've paid attention to most of my life. And Jacksonville Beach is a great, great place to live. Lived here for 30 years, work here, raise kids here. And, you know, it's just, we have a little bit of an identity issue, and we've had that. And I'm just like, you know, this may be something kind of cool to present to the beach's, you know, leaders, the leadership, and see if we can pull this together on a public-private sort of aspect. Because I knew I couldn't do it by myself. Obviously, the idea was, can we do an event in the plaza with lifeguard chairs, bring businesses together, all this kind of crazy stuff, and pull it off in a few months? I mean, that was September, I think, and I'm like, going, this is a lot. And I do that to myself anyways, but. So we got buy-in from the city, and we got buy-in from the lifeguards, and, you know, at the time, it was kind of confusing because there was this guy with this crazy idea to decorate lifeguard chairs, and I had to pull a program together rather quickly and share it with businesses and nonprofits. And as I was doing the work, it was becoming more and more real to me that not only was I going to be able, if we could, you know, at least have the semblance of an idea that would cap, you know, that people could understand. It's community, it's public art, it's the core, which is identity. You know, it's Christmas, it's holidays. We haven't done, apparently, the people in Palo Tower have been picking on George for years about Christmas, and where, I'm sorry, George, you deserve that. That was your one. So I was timing this thing really at the right time, and the city leaders, you know, met with me, Charlie and George, and the folks at the lifeguards, and it just came together. I mean, it was I just have to say, it was kind of special the way it happened. And I was able to commit about 16 businesses to decorate chairs. I was the decorator, the designer for most of these businesses, obviously, because no one knew about decorating a lifeguard chair. What do you do? How do you do it? No one wanted to even touch that one. I'm like, man, you just make it big, that's all, and put a bunch of lights on, it'll be cool. So then that really was it. It was like, this is what you gotta do, it'll be cool. And I'll never forget the day when, it was right after the Celtic Festival, and we had built a Donna chair just to give people a general idea of how this could work, and showed it at the Celtic Festival. And that next couple of days when they cleared the pavilion area, or the Latham Plaza area, and had red lifeguard chairs all lined up in a schematic based on what I provided them, I was just blown away. I mean, these red chairs were just sitting out there waiting for me to decorate. It was like, oh gosh, it's Christmas, it's so cool. So we had volunteers. John, thank you, he was one of the first out there, and we had the Corps was out there, and we had, it's just a few really dedicated build guys that I just found by luck, just by luck. You know, hey, do you know how to build stuff? I started sending guys about a month out templates and drawings, and here's what this chair is going to look like, and here's what this one's going to look like, and they just started building at their homes and stuff. And then the plan was, once the chairs were out, we would do what we could to get them all together and start erecting these things and put lights on them. So it was beautiful. I mean, it really worked. It was kind of neat. We went there for an opening and turned on the lights and had a little kind of speak there with about 100 people, 150, 200 people, and had some music playing there, and just watched it happen over the next month. And that was the other cool part. The city gave me the space for an entire month. I went there every night. I did. It was just so cool. In fact, I remember the first night, actually, the night before when Firehouse set up their chair, because that was really the first one I could test. And before we turned on the lights, they had theirs all set up, and I went there Thanksgiving night. It was Thanksgiving night, it was cold, and there was no decorating done except for theirs. The guy had to leave, like, the state on some kind of Thanksgiving holiday thing, and so he just built his. There was one chair built, and I went there, at like 8:30 that night, 9 o'clock, and I turned that thing on. There's a chair turned sideways, looked like a fire. I guess he said it looked like a fire engine. To me, it just looked like some sticks and some lights. But man, when I turned that thing on, it was a fire truck. And I was just like, this is it. So, but going back every night, watching kids and watching adults and just seeing that plaza turn into something. I've been to music festivals in Jacks Beach, and I've been to, some events that take place in Jacks Beach, and they're all wonderful events, and they're done the right way, and handled by, talented people. But this is the first time I saw that area used for art, used for like creativity, and then used in a way that actually families and visitors could actually enjoy it. Walk that space and see the, look over to the dunes and see that the beach is on the other side, and there's our, it was just special. So I knew I was locked in after that. And after it wrapped and there were no accidents, incidents, we had a couple blown fuses and things like that. We managed every night. It was awesome. So I'm going to show you what Deck the Chairs is becoming, because I put myself in deep this time. And that's not unusual for me. So we started working immediately right at the end of Deck the Chairs 2013 and became a nonprofit. I got my nonprofit status somewhere halfway through this year, and a group of about 12 folks were part of this committee. And there's, it's too boring to talk about all the details, but I'm learning to become a nonprofit and grow up, I guess. But it's work, it's a lot of work. And this is a sample of what we are in the midst of doing right now with Deck the Chair. I designed this early in the year. I had this vision that maybe not only do we get Latham Plaza, but maybe the city will let us have both properties. Because I knew one day if we were lucky enough, we might be able to have some performances and do some things with programming. So I just kind of boldly said, maybe we can get the city to, and I designed and decorated this idea where we make it a place to visit and turn it into something kind of quirky, like a combination Whoville / Nemo thing, and just have this really neat display going on. And the city bought it. And they said, okay, Curtis, do you think you can build it? I know that's happened many times. I'm sorry, George. So I had this design for the pavilion area, and I still have the design for the Latham Plaza area, so now I'm doubling my number of chairs. I'm telling the city, I think we can address the pavilion in a way where it's really cool and beautiful. We can get a tree done and have these big sculptures with big lights, and then keep the exhibit going on the other side. I think we could have a really neat energy between the two places. And so these are our sponsors. I just want to say that the top row are the folks that are sponsoring big pieces. And when I say big, you can kind of get an idea. A chair is generally 9 feet tall. So this is about 9 feet, so that's about 16 feet. All these things are like big. A lot of metal. They're built out of, it's 3/4 inch, 1 inch conduit by a company, artistic contractors here in Atlantic Beach, Florida. I found them by just a miracle. They were recommended by a lady that is with UNF doing their sculptural department over at UNF, and she knows the big dogs that do build in Jacksonville. And this company does stuff for Disney. They do stuff for parks and theme, places all over the world. And they win awards. I mean, they win international awards. The guys are so talented, they shouldn't even, it's like, for them to look at my concepts and say, yeah, we'll build that first, let's do it, and get excited, I was just so flattered. So anyways, I'm gonna get into some of the stuff they're doing. But before I do that, this is the beneficiary. So, yeah, the lifeguards. Some people ask, were you ever a lifeguard? I'm like, nope, never a lifeguard. Why are you doing this for the lifeguard? It's really just kind of a fluky thing where the chairs really are special. I know what the course is about. I've learned a lot. I've worked on stuff for the lifeguards even in the past when they didn't know I was working on it, because a friend would hire me and say, hey, we're going to be doing this for one of the anniversaries 20 years ago or 30 years ago. But great deal of respect for them. Great deal of respect for the history. So, I mean, I dug into learning more and more about the lifeguards and understanding who this beneficiary was and knowing, wow, at 102 years old, this is, and from where they, I mean, honestly, they've grown up as an organization, and, you know, I just have a huge respect for them. And so we do this for the lifeguards, but we do it for the community, and we do it for the kids. There's just a lot of levels with this. And I'm going to let, if you're willing, we'll talk a little bit about that in a moment. How the funds could be used, because they operate with very little money, guys. It's crazy how little they operate on. I set this up. This is kind of a by the numbers. This is kind of fun just to sort of go over with you. Last year, we had 20 chairs. 12 were done by private companies or, you know, just businesses. 8 were nonprofits. We had about 48 volunteers. We were in the pavilion or Latham Plaza for 36 days. We had, what I did, and I promise you, I went there every day and on weekends, and we had about 50,000 visitors come through the pavilion. We had, you know, a bunch of some media, not a lot. We just didn't have a lot of money. We raised about $9,000 to do all this. And we still cut a check to the Corps for $1,800 at the end of it. So obviously, it was a lot of pro bono work being done. This year, you know, it showed some information when the board was formed and when we got our status. 36 chairs are actually what are going to occupy the plaza and the pavilion. We have a tree this year that is incredible. You're going to see pictures of it. It's going to blow minds. I mean, it's the most unique Christmas tree ever built, ever designed in the world. I mean, I'm telling you, it's beautiful. It's got ornaments that you can see right here that all of our sponsors are going to get. In fact, we're selling ornaments to help pay for some of the things. So these are plexi ornaments that are about 18 inches, custom design. The sponsors, if they're a sponsor, they get one for free. If you want to just have an ornament and help us pay for things, it's $80. 40 of it goes to the cost of the ornament, 40 goes to the lifeguard. So that's basically how it's set up. I'll show you a picture of a collectible tree ornament we've designed. It's about 3.5-4 inches tall. Beautiful. We're going to try to sell those as well. We've raised $57,000, which, again, from $9,000 to $57,000 is huge. I mean, that is like, I've talked to people and they go, oh, deck the chairs, that was so cool. And we want to be a part of it. And then others, you know, I go back and meet with them 10 times. You know, I just got to go back. I can't, you know, I know they should do it. I really, really think it's a perfect fit for them. This is me. I'm just going to say, I was telling someone earlier, our company, as a small business, we've got, when this all wraps this year, we'll have over 600 hours into deck the chairs from the beginning of February till December. Easy. And I'm not even, I'm embarrassed or not. I don't even write my hours on the timesheet sometimes. But we think 150,000 people are going to come to the pavilion and come and visit this year. We think we're going to get 150,000, not only because we're going to do enough marketing for deck the chairs, and we know by the way it's been designed and created that there will be people just wanting to see it personally. But we're connected to Beaches Baptist Hospital. We're connected to Bailey's Powerhouse Gym now. We're connected to Native Sun. So they have databases that are 7,000 members or 7,000 people that follow their brand or, you know, they're part of them. So they're going to push out to their members and to their friends and to their families, hey, come visit us at Deck the Chairs. So we, and just by nature of social media, I think it's going to get a huge, there's going to be a huge benefit to this year, even over last year. And we even have Santa, right? Mm-hmm. Right. Don't worry, I got it taken care of. All right, so here's some programming. This is what we plan to do. November 24th, hopefully sometime that week, George, we move the Corps, we move the red chairs into the space. It's right after the Celtic Festival, is what we did last year. This is kind of going to go like clockwork eventually, hopefully. The decorating will go from 28th to 29th. We did this last year. It's 2 full days of just a lot of people building, hammering, sawing, cutting, painting, you know, just making things happen. A lot of wrapping lights. We need people to help wrap lights. If you want to help, that's what we need. And then on the 30th, we'll probably still be working on everything. That's when we want to turn all the lights on, but also we know we're probably going to be working on stuff still. And then we have planned some things for that night. We're going to do some announcements. We're going to have a little bit of music, and we will turn it on in a really cool fashion. We had a programming meeting today. We've got some plans to make it really cool when we turn these lights on, so you don't want to miss it, but it's just not a big deal. The big deal is December 14th, and we'll have a holiday, a really more traditional holiday celebration. Nancy Dance Studios are going to be there. Hopefully Santa Claus is there. He's a terrific Santa Claus, by the way. Music that's being handled by Brass. There's just a terrific group of people that have connections with the symphony. We're doing this collectible ornaments thing. And, oh, I missed the bean gift bucket. Get gift buckets. So get ready to see this tree. I'm going to show you the tree. The tree came out of this idea. These are my sketches. These happened in January, February. I was sketching stuff out. Like, I wanted big waves, I wanted cool things, and I wanted a cool tree. So this tree was looking like, you know, Dr. Seuss, who built trees? And that's exactly what he was like, man, can we do this? I bet we can. Hey, you can do anything. You just don't be scared. Just draw and say, hey, build this. So I actually took these sketches to this company, Artistic Contractors, showed them these big, big plans, and check this out. These guys started building my tree. So there's my tree, or the tree, and it is like 17 feet tall. But as I'm building it, I'm like, you know, everyone does those trees where they're just decorative and they sit in a place and they don't mean anything. And, you know, and fir trees, you ship them in from someplace, it costs a ton of money, and then you end up, you know, sitting and looking at it. Where your Christmas tree at home usually has gifts underneath it and stuff, right? And so I'm like, man, we should have a tree that has gifts. Well, how do you do that? Well, you gotta make a base for it and have a way to put gifts under it. So what I did next is I went to the guys and I said, I have this idea. Can we put buckets in sand and ocean waves and like empty buckets, and we can invite the community to come and bring like food for bean? You know, we can get the whole community to kind of come together and bring stuff like non-perishables for bean. And they're like, dude, yeah, of course we can build that. And so I sketched that up. And we now have these big, beautiful bean buckets. Here's my sketches again. So we have these, and they're getting built right now, and I'm going to show you pictures of these things. It's just so cool. Four of these you can kind of see, you know, around the perimeter. And then look at these waves they're building. These are all handcrafted, hand-sculpted. They're just gorgeous. And these craftsmen just totally get it. I think I'm going to be allowed to paint the waves, which is going to be fun. So, and here's the guys working on the metal sculpture work. I mean, it's this craftsman that just, obviously I sound like a geek talking about it, but I think when people see this all come together and all in the pavilion, all wrapped in lights, painted and wrapped in lights, the photographs that are going to be taken, the stuff that's going to be shared, the tree. Look at this elf. That's for Beaches Baptist Hospital. What I'm doing is every one of these things has like a purpose, like you can interact. So this Dr. Elf has a stethoscope right about body part height. So you just stand right there and get your little picture taken by the elf. Right here, you step inside the sleigh with Santa Claus. So there's a big, you know, panel for the sleigh, and you step behind the panel right beside inside with Santa Claus. And this is, you know, instead of a reindeer, you got us a seahorse. And these big surfboards, you just step up onto the surfboard, and you're in a 17-foot tall ocean wave. And this one over here, big snow globe, there's going to be little beach chairs in there. You can just get in the lounge chair and get your picture taken. They're planning on having snow, a snow globe, like blowing around in there. And I'm like, dude, do it. That's perfect. Then this is obviously a little looking like a stork with the baby bundle, and people can just kind of stand in and behind the baby bundle, like they're in the baby bundle, and get pictures taken that way. So it's all kind of interactive and fun for pictures, and you know, it's just pretty exciting, and I'm glad I was able to share some of this. This is the layout of the pavilion. You can see all the people that we've gotten involved. I mean, we have, of the 24, it's an equal split. We've got, I think, about 12 nonprofits, and we have about 12 for-profits. So the cool thing is we're actually bringing people together. I mean, where sometimes they're in their little silos, and one person's doing one thing, and they're raising money over here, and they you got Beatrice Habitat. By the way, I'm sorry, I cut your logo right in half. Right when you walked in, I was like, dang it. But yeah, you know, there's like multiple nonprofits that are sitting side by side in this area, and they all get to promote themselves. They all get to kind of share that they're beach businesses, beach nonprofits, and they're part of the community. And all we have to do is convince George to give us a little music, and everything will be perfect.
Oh.
So here's a couple more pictures from last. John, how about that? There you go. More. It was really pretty. I would go by there on my morning runs, and you know, the light would just be right, and I would just be, man, this thing is the coolest. And then at times at night, you know, kids were out and families were out, and that, it would always tickle me if I got there and there were like 20 kids all running around, and you know, the bubbles would be coming out of the one chair, the bubbles machine. Those little kids, man, they played in the bubbles for hours. And then this is the ornament program again. We have it online, www.deckthechairs.org. And you can order an ornament, it's really easy. And we have shells and sand dollars in three different colors. And then one more thing, we had a media kind of day, and here's how these things look kind of in real life, heights and stuff. Pretty dramatic. It's way right here again. So. The guys did a terrific job. This is me cutting a check last year to the Corps. It was about 19. It's going to be interesting what we have left. I'm trying my best to, man, when you're sitting there having to buy, and I'm learning this, but we have a big, big capital expenditure with all this stuff. I mean, so we are literally building stuff that we won't build next year. That tree will cost us about 20 grand. When it's all said and done. Originally, when I budgeted with the city, the tree was like 6,500. I had never built a Christmas tree before. I'm just guessing. I'm saying, how about 6,500? Then I'm actually building it, and I'm adding buckets to it, and sand, and all this crazy stuff. And it's like, well, let's borrow from, what is the saying? Borrow from Peter or Paul. We did that. So that's how we ran out of the sound stuff. Anyways. We still cut a check last year, we're going to cut a check this year, but I guarantee next year, when we do this again, there's going to be a check made out to the lifeguards that is going to rock them. So I can't wait to do that. We'll have a much bigger check than $2,000 this year. I don't know what it's going to be, but it's going to be much bigger than $2,000. And just, yeah, volunteer, help us, support us. It's cool. This is base, that was it. All right. So, do you want to speak just a little bit?
Does he have time to just talk about the Corps? Just a minute.
George, he doesn't like me because I don't send him photos. I'm just kidding. But I do owe him photographs. George, are you part of this with the lifeguards?
Yes. I'm George Hapsis. I was a 1950 lifeguard at Jacksonville Beach. I grew up to become an architect. Worked for the state of Florida, was on your school board for 5 years. Fletcher High School is one of the projects that I worked on while I was with the school board. Now that I am retired from inspecting hospitals and nursing homes for the state, throughout my lifetime I have done a lot of volunteer work. I've worked at five historical places. I worked at Beaches Historical Society as a volunteer for about 4 or maybe 5 years after I started doing the archival things for the Life Saving Corps. So that's who I am. I'm a native person from Jacksonville on the beach. I don't think any of you are young enough to remember the tropical restaurant at Jacksonville Beach, but that was my father's. Anyway, this thing excited me last year. I was out during the construction at night, daytime, taking pictures, trying to get something in our archives. I think I've got something. You've got more. I still want all this stuff you promised me. So, the Corps has benefited from the proceeds last year. I can't tell you exactly what they've done with the funds they got because we're always so strapped for money that I don't know what a good example is. It's like getting a tooth pulled. You you finally get the money to purchase something just needed. This gives us hope. There are several other changes that are happening at the lifeguard station. The Red Cross is sort of stepping back. We have a new name coming up, a foundation. I heard that George was here. Which one is George Fields? Okay, I've been up to his office to meet him about 5 times and I've never gotten there.
Uh-oh. You're going to meet him tonight.
Oh, good. That's good.
Don't get me in too much trouble, George.
I'm not trying to get you in trouble. How many chairs do you need?
We're at 36.
Well, I think I've been building about 20 of them.
Yeah.
I've taken some time off from my archival chores because it's relaxing to me to put a tool in my hand and build something. So I've been down there several times and I've built somewhere between 10 and 20 chairs. And I've enjoyed every moment of it. And I'm anxious to see them up this year. I wasn't prepared to say anything. I'm doing this because he asked me when I walked in.
That covers most of it for this year. I'd be more than happy to answer some questions right now. Anything. Just got it. There we go.
So have you, you've already sold all the chairs at this point for this year?
Pretty much, yeah. Yeah, I mean, there's going to be a chance that we end up modifying or adjusting. I have a plan for all the chairs, where they're going to go. Most everyone's in some state of design. There's some people that are waiting here for me. And, you know, it's like if I add another one or figure that out, it's got to be someone that can almost take it and go, you know, and not really lay a lot of responsibility on us. Which, I mean, I'm okay with that. It's interesting, the pricing on this year, we went up a little bit, but the goal was, just so you know, we had this level where they're building these chairs, I'm building these sculptures. We know that the tree and these things can sustain for like 3 years. We're hoping that someone comes back again and again and again. And what we do is add more to it. That's kind of the idea. So those things, you know, will cost us with lights and metal and all that. And it's a $1,600 investment and something in that neighborhood. And I price these things, so that's a good deal. Believe me, the metal work and so I'm really confident that's a good deal. But we won't spend that next year. You know, it's done. But with the, you know, where was I going with it? The other chairs were like at a 1,400 range, and what I was planning to do, we were about $1,000 last year, and it's really interesting because advertising, marketing, and views, and you know, people like to figure out what the return on investment is going to be and all that kind of stuff. So that's why I'm really pushing into the social media. The point was going to be I wanted $400, and it has worked to an extent, $400 to go to the artist build team. The goal is to one day really, really, really turn this into a very cool, creative event for the entire city of Jackson. I mean, not just beach people. Beach people, if that's all we limit it to, and that's all they want to do, it, fine. But if we want to get artists from the region coming in and decorating, designing and decorating the coolest chairs ever, then we're going for it. I mean, I want these things to be interactive and cool and just like kids, just when they see them, they just smile. The whole idea is just put a smile on people's face. So the plan will always be money budgeted for art, design, build, be able to pay for the things, and then write a good check for the core. And Mike, yeah, I think we'll be writing checks to these guys in a few years that are in the 30,000 to 40,000 range. That's my goal here. I really think we'll get there. I think this will grow over the 5 years, maybe 10 for the rest of it. I mean, we could look at this as something that other cities may take on. I mean, I don't think it's a crazy thought that another coastal community looks at Deck the Chairs, sees how it's doing, what it does for the lifeguards, and they say, we want to participate. We'll even compete with you guys. We'll do our deck of chairs, you can do your deck of chairs, and you know, who knows? It may all start something really cool across the coastal communities. Never know. Anything else?
Yeah, I know you're saving these huge, big structures because that's going to make it easier next year and more economical. What happens to them during the off season.
Right, storage.
Storage, yeah, we worked on that. And again, I've got to tell you, we started meeting monthly, and the city's been really good about, you know, committing to our meetings, making sure there's someone from the city that's been a part of every one of our meetings. So when it comes to production on chairs, building chairs, when it comes to new stuff, we're talking right away. How's it going to be stored? How's it going to be transported? All this is being, you know, coordinated right now. All these chairs, it's really, these guys are geniuses. I mean, they get built to be 16 feet, but we break them down and they can both be put on a trailer. And they can all be slid, because they're flat. Generally, they're flat. They can all be stored and fit into a big container box.
Curtis, where are they going to be stored?
City property, I heard. or your apartment. Or your apartment.
We have a site.
Yeah.
Is there a minimum age? Because I've got some middle schoolers who
no
are...
No minimum age. In fact, the wrapping of the lights is a really great, I think it's a great community service kind of thing, if we can, you know, bring some of those people into it. There'd be a lot of lights to wrap.
Okay.
Yes?
So I have a question about all these people above are your sponsors, correct?
Right.
Okay. So, for example, Baptist. Did they pay for the construction of their elf, or did they just give you a flat X amount of sponsorship?
Flat fee. I went at it with the, I called this, Georgia didn't like me to say this out loud, I called it Seaville, off of Sea Walk, but I needed to call it like a place. We won't say that out loud in front of George. Whenever he's around,
we'll
say that.
No, he's
still there?
As far as I know.
So anyways, the idea was I had a general idea of the cost going in, and I just didn't feel like we were ready to really make it a big deal from us, you know, how much we could try to raise from a sponsor. So it's, you know, we tried to just, here's what it costs, if we can get double that and receive, you know, back money for the core, that'll work. Does that make sense? No, not really.
Well, I'm just curious. For example, how much would the elf cost you to build?
They all generally cost me $1,600. $1,200 to do all the metal work and then paint them, and then we wrap them in lights, and it's about another $300 to $400 in lights.
Okay. So I'm just curious, like, Baptist wouldn't have given you like a $2,000 sponsorship, or why wouldn't you have tried to cover the cost of the build the first year through the sponsorship money?
I did.
Oh, you did? Okay, yeah. So it does...
That's what I'm saying, yeah. The $2,600 that they gave us...
Oh, they gave you $2,600.
Yes, okay, and all of them are generally... They're all paying the same sponsor. Yeah.
Okay.
So that's my high level, mm-hmm. And then my low level is, well, not low, but $1,400, mm-hmm. And then I have a $700 level. Yeah, so it's... Yeah. And I mean, it's kind of weird. I'm trying to figure this stuff out, what my base might be, and what people can sustain. Yes, sir.
So, Fletcher High School's got some service clubs.
Right.
We can try to get them involved.
I would love it.
Okay.
Yeah, and again, the phone number is on the website. I think we've got some material around. You can reach me at 716-3853. Yeah. And, again, there's a lot still being done. We still have to buy a lot of stuff. I haven't even ordered all my lights for this. I'm going to do a big light order. The way this tree's, I'll just say this real quick. The way this tree's going to work, you have the gifting buckets down here, and you have all that beautiful sculpture work. And then this thing is going to be wrapped in a green mesh light, the green net stuff. And we've ordered like 36 panels of that. And we're going to wrap the entire tree. And then we're going to come back one more time with multicolor lights. Then we're going to come back with 80 ornaments. And then we've got a star. The star that goes on the top of this, this is 52 inches tall. It's almost, you know, it's over 4 feet of star. And all these are bursts of light that kind of look like little spotlights. It's just of everything, we don't blow the power. Yes.
Curtis, the buckets, are they going to be each day?
We're only going to do it that one night. Yeah. We're not going to keep stuff in the buckets. Yeah, and in fact, who knows what's going to show up in those buckets?
Police department is involved in the planning, so there's another one, so they can provide security.
Yeah, I think that's a big deal. You don't quite know how crazy this could get, because these things look like jungle gyms.
Yeah.
Yeah, and there's people.
That they're pretty athletic people.
Or they think
they're athletic. We had security on the weekends, and then they had, I know that they were setting it up where they were writing and doing some of the reporting and some of their work on in parking lots nearby. They know, they're pretty well aware of this thing. So I'm really excited. I really appreciate you listening and
If you buy one of these ornaments, do you get to keep it?
Yes. Oh, that's another point, yeah. You buy an ornament. You have the ornament on the tree for the 30 plus days. We take it down and we give it to you, and you can use it again next year. You have to—it's half price next year. Wow, it is. We're coming back in for $40.
You can get it annually. I'm thinking, you know, I might want to hang them on my house annually. Get one each year.
You said that there was three colors.
Yeah, there's a yellow, a tealish blue, and like that, and then the pinkish color—yellow, pink, and blue—and we're at 60. Some ornaments already, so yeah, it's gonna be, yeah, we're starting as people learn this. So thank you guys.
Thank you guys for coming.